We are doing the last little bit of today's stream. Are you gonna take a quick AFK, silly? I guess you already did. Okay, so what we're doing here is we gotta go to Biovac 4. I'm not sure which one is Biovac 4 or if we already have it or not. We gotta head south, so I assume that it's over here. The exit is at F8 in the Calmere Drift, so that's F8? So I guess it's over here. So we gotta go head down here. Okay, got a good idea of where we need to go, so we can work that out here in a moment. Let me go back to... This is gonna be cool, though, 'cause we haven't been here before. We actually haven't done the quest to break the ice wall yet. We may have to do that at some point. Really, though, we just need some gear with some better accuracy, I think. That'll help us out. Are there any, like, rings in that that are good for accuracy? Because right now I'm using, Yeah, there's a quest in the zone for that.
Hello, hello.
Hello.
I don't know what happened. I think my
I accidentally reloaded
my page and it like turned the sound back onto the stream, so it's probably playing while that's gone. I don't know how that happened.
All right, in the zone we're going to. Okay. Items. We are gonna grab abilities. Let's keep ourselves. Okay, I'm guessing I'm riding the raptor. It's not what I wanted, but.
But you get the raptor, that's too bad.
That's alright, the raptor doesn't get enough love.
That's true, it really kinda doesn't.
Hello, Yusuf! Hello! There's a +7 accuracy ring and a +7 attack ring. Do you know the name of that? I could look into getting it. Gaming's like my own personal FFclopedia. Oh, that's right, we can't go through here, we gotta go the long way. You still following me, silly?
Yeah.
Behemoth's ring, okay. Without having to go through the list, is there any merits that enhance accuracy, or...? Or should Silly... Because I know there's some job point bonuses that enhance accuracy. So, maybe Silly and I should focus on just doing some job leveling every now and then.
You mean like for job points?
Yeah.
There's job points that give accuracy?
Kind of, like, you know, the bonuses you get for them.
Yeah. That's true.
That's what I was thinking anyway. I'm pretty sure there is. Oh yeah, there's physical accuracy bonuses you can get, and we get the next one at a long time from now. At 280 points. Okay, so that one's not feasible to work on. Well, in the strictest sense. Yeah.
So from the one from the Wildskeeper, the Reeve that we do after the next one that we have in our intermediate list, we get like dagger and hand-to-hand items.
Yeah.
Gives you the dagger gives me dagger skill plus 242, parry plus 242, magic accuracy plus 188.
Magic accuracy.
I know. There might be another weapon. I should take a look and see what other weapons there are. Let's see. Says dagger, there's a sword, great sword, an axe, great axe, scythe, pole arm. Looks like that might be the only dagger from that particular set.
Interesting.
It's okay. The next one gives us the Yorsha Wield Skirmish, and you need to you get a piece of armor piece for 119 from skirmish armor.
Okay, so yeah, we can't break this wall yet.
We don't
have the quest for it. Lady Reaper, are you able to break this wall down? Magic has to also for skills like AoE and Ancillary.
Wait, what? Oh, magic helps with what?
AoE and Edge.
Ah.
Livened ring is the other one, okay.
Apparently later on, basically you trade your 109 chest piece to this person and they upgrade it for you. Then you can trade your 109 head helm piece to them and they upgrade it to 119.
Oh.
So what are we gonna do here since we can't do this?
We're gonna kill the animals and hopefully
it's gonna kill you too. Yeah, Jungle World Koromaru will heal you. Summon Pharaoh's Coffin!
Sorry. I have to get something to take the threat off me.
Well, it's only fair that I die twice. It gives me time to read this thing. And then after the next one, you do this other skirmish thing, and it gives you you can get a 119 Illuvian skirmish weapon, which includes some good, maybe good weapons for it.
Hey, Koromaru, you want to cast a heal on me, buddy?
Nope.
Oh, refresh. All right, that's a good plan. Valinor is dead because they wasn't fucking doing anything. My chests are just standing there like idiots.
Well, they may have been like affected by something. Quick, summon Pharaoh's Coffin and attack them. Maybe he'll rescue.
I'm gonna go down to my left.
I think it's Pharaoh's Coffin.
Can't actually do any damage to this, so. I don't have the item, but I'm just attacking. Hello, Yusuf. Sorry I wasn't ignoring you. How are you doing?
Oh, it's casting something.
It's not res yet. Oh, there he is, casting raise 3.
Yeah. And a long cast time. Oh yeah.
I'm back. Lady Reaper's low on health.
Can't damage
these
things,
right? No, we can't. We can't. So it's gonna be a few moments.
Where are you attacking?
I'm attacking the left one. Something I can do to it.
Okay. Just giving you something to do.
Well, that, and it keeps heals on Lady Reaper if she gets attacked by something.
That's true.
How you doing, Yusuf? How's everyone doing today? Well, come on, let's talk Final Fantasy. Who's all here is excited for Stormblood?
Yeah.
Lady Reaper, thank you very much for assisting us by breaking down this ice wall. I am perfectly fine, Yusuf. What's that, silly?
It's the guy at the pub's about doing the intermediate stuff.
Cool. So, are you okay with working on that this week, then?
Yeah, we can do that.
I know I keep tacking on things we need to do, but I figure this is so that we can get through this.
If we can complete this, we'll have 119 artifact headpiece, artifact chest piece, and then hands, glove, and feet. Hands, glove, or feet from skirmish and weapons. And then we may be able to get another piece. I don't know how that works, though.
Yeah, so I figure if we can complete this, then that means that we should have the gear to do with the rest of the content. And when we do, that means we should be able to not have any issues. That'll leave it open for us to do other things.
Mm-hmm.
You're excited for FF15 because your friend's giving you your PS4? That's awesome!
What?
And Nier Automata. I'm really excited for Nier. Like, I really want to play this series, but I'm also putting it off because I haven't played Dragon Quest yet. But yeah, so... Oh, Gammy, I am not looking forward to doing the stuff needed for the... epilogue of Adeline. There's just so much stuff there, and if it wasn't for the imprimters, like getting legendary with every coalition, I would be more desiring to do it, but that just requires a lot of time, and I don't have that much time, and it's all on the... Alright. We might as well mount so that we don't aggro anything else. Like, yeah, you get it. Like, and I want to show off everything I can in the game, but that might be one thing I just gotta not do. You know?
Yeah.
Like, I'm gonna do my best to get it, but I, may have to wait until after I'm done. Yeah, see, so there's a lot of stuff there. And then I gotta go and find a way to kill all the Knackles, which... That one we only killed because, like, a whole bunch of other people came to help. But is that gonna be the case every time? Or... Yeah. Alright, man, how much time do I have to wait? 10 seconds, okay. And then we'll ride the war machine. So that might be one piece of content that I can't show on stream. I may just record it later or something, but then it requires me to continue paying for the game after I've done everything I want to do, so I may not do that. Especially if the next game I get that Silly and I decide to stream is a pay game.
Dragon Quest X?
Oh, if it's Dragon Quest X, well then. Yeah, I don't have time to sit online waiting for shouts for a Wildkeeper Reef. Hi, Rodrigo Chapa! It's been 10 years. I can understand why you missed it. It is a pretty awesome game. It's just a huge time sink at a lot of points. It looks like your red sickness is gone.
It's good.
What class did you play when you played Rodrigo?
Right in the one spot that I couldn't, like, follow you. Is this it?
I think. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's hear the music of this place. Well, Gammy says it's good. 34 gigabytes on near. I don't have a map here. I may not have loaded yet. Oh, I do have a map. Okay, what the fuck is this? We're back in Romave? Not Romave, Guns. Hello, Lorene.
How is there a person in here?
You can voice Lorene.
My name is, Lorene. I visit ruins all around Vanadiel in pursuit of ancient knowledge. Rakhaznazar is positively overflowing with all manner of shadows. If they don't keep their number of us under control, they might spill out into the wildlands. If they were just feral fiends, I'd say throw caution to the wind and call them right now. But I sense there's some greater presence guiding them. I'd advise you to take care of the mystical barricades that line this place should you decide to take the beast on. Those doors have a mind of their own and are apt to trap you within the labyrinth. It's as if the walls themselves are alive, with energies pulsing through their cracks like the blood in our veins. And those energies are no ordinary magic. You could try to rend them to taters with a great axe, but the only thing to splinter would be its hilt. Taters. If your goal is to colonize this land, then you'll need to find a way to deal with such obstacles. I'll do a little bit of experimentation and see if I can find anything. And by I mean we. I would expect no less. If you find something with traces of arcane energies, come back to me. Perhaps I can learn more about its form and function. With any luck, I'll be able to fashion a pattern that'll turn the energies to our benefit. What's a pattern? A pattern is a magical apparatus to convert cyclical magic into simple formulas. Leave the details to me. For you, a grasp of the basics will suffice. First things first. Find something with remnants of this energy and bring it back here. Then we can get to its work. I would venture 2 squares of ancestral cloth should suffice. If I'm right, the shadows wandering about the inner court should have some on them.
Yes, I've got to.
Defeat monsters? Not my thing. Excellent! The two of us will make a perfect team!
Alright, we'll worry about that after. Okay, so that's a quest we can finish at any point. For now, go to L8 and send the birds. So, items. Is stuff here gonna murder us, Lady Reaper?
Oh, why do I have this equipped?
It is kind of epic sounding, Ogami. I really like it. You played Warrior. Warrior is the class that I actually played when I first played the game. I was a warrior ninja. No clue, first time here? Alright. So if we die, we're gonna go down in a blaze of glory.
For some reason I had a Hume vest on, and I don't know how that happened. This isn't the first time that's happened.
Alright, so we gotta go to L8. Okay, so let's look at the map. 8. L is right there. Okay, we gotta go this way, I think. Try the most obvious path first. I like to see this area though. It's got a bit of a different design than anything we've seen so far.
Yeah, it's like a spaceship. An evil spaceship underneath the ground.
You were in here and Sparks Gear and survived? Okay, well, we're a little better geared than Sparks Gear, so. At least 0.5% greater. Alright.
Not even really, but yeah.
We are in. Okay. Ha! Twined roots. Out of range. Let's go to the other side. Send? Yes. Yeah. So we gotta go west, one square, it says. And destroy amaranth barriers. You'll download it during the night. Good plan, Yusuf. That's usually the best time to download stuff. That's usually when I do most of my downloading too. Like Grim Dawn, I downloaded that in the evening one night. So where are Amaranthian bearers? It says one square west away is it. At H9. See any Amaranthian barriers here?
No.
Hi, the Shan. How's it going? Welcome to the stream. Alright, let's head over to H9, I guess. Hey, somebody here. It's maybe a good place to level, silly.
Maybe.
Oh, this is J11. That's not where we want to go. Actually, yes, it is. Never mind. We should be okay. Okay, there's a colonization wave. Cool. You're downloading the game right now? Excellent. Have you played before, or are you looking to start anew? Shunned elementalist. Well, if you're living down here, I can see why you're shunned. Why am I targeting Olmia?
Why not? That's the question. Is it?
Play back in 0709? Okay, yeah, we got, I think this is it. Vertical transition
device. Vertical
transit
device.
Okay, let's click it.
Going up.
Yeah, okay, it's the elevator.
Something's tickling my eye with it.
When you reach advisor in all coalitions, you hold up to 16 imprimators and they respawn every 330 minutes instead of 360 minutes. Well, that would speed things up significantly, even though it doesn't sound like it. Okay, well, I'm only advisor in one coalition. I've just been, oops, that's not what I wanted to do. All right, so from here it says, okay, on map one, go to I-11 and wide scan for an NPC named Effigy of Ceiling. So I-11, or is that L-11? Might be L-11. Okay, no, it's definitely I. So we are heading to I-11, which is down there. Okay, it's pretty much directly south of us. We can get there regardless of the path we take. So if we can go left or right, we'll get there. Assuming there's nothing blocking our path, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Did you tank as a warrior, Shen, or did you Are you DPSing? Oh shit.
They're attacking us. Yeah, we should.
Hit me for 92, so that's fine.
I can't get to it because I've been slapping for a minute, so.
That's fine.
I might get woken up. Nope, I won't get woken up because the thing that was going to attack me is now attacking the Reaper.
So would you so what you're advising is I get advisor in all of them and then work on getting legend in all of them? I may end up doing that actually. That sounds like a much better idea. What do you think, Silly?
Sure.
Okay, these things hurt, but they're not deadly. It's not like the fucking bomb. Unless they explode. If these things explode, fuck everything. I quit this game. Ah, shit, one of them attacking.
Miracorn.
Yeah. Job point, Silly.
Nice.
What should I have? Oh, okay, they don't get very much capacity points. We are currently on Ashura, Shen. I think it's the most populated North American server, so if you're looking for people to play with, this is definitely where you should be. We started on Ragnarok, but it wasn't good. As Silly and I have said before, hey, congrats, Lady Reaper. As Silly and I have pointed out, we were pretty much the only people who played on Ragnarok, so we kind of swapped to Ashura for that reason.
It's true. Also, those guys give quite a bit of limit points.
Limit or capacity?
Limit,
yeah.
I gained 2 merit points in that exchange.
Yeah, they're pretty good. I still think Terrier Chucks are better because for leveling job levels, just because they give more job EXP.
That's probably true.
You serious? Can we not get through here? I hate everything. I hate everything right so much right now. And then the game will go and do something like that. Not to worry, there's 3 other paths we can take to get in there, so if one doesn't work, try the next 3.
It's always fun to me that monsters who can acrobat sight
don't. Right. Sorry. Ogami, we did have Ionis up, but we kind of, as you know, we died, so it kind of fell off. So we'll have to get that back. It gives a bonus to capacity points, so we'll need to get that when we go to level, Silly.
Just in general, or?
It gives a bonus to capacity points in Adlin.
Oh. I don't level here. I'm not good enough.
Or something? No? Okay. Oh, look! The door is open! Fuck this entire game. Alright. There's ooze things here. Right, let's just bypass that. Go to aisle 11. Alright, we're in aisle 11 and it says, do a wide scan for an NPC statue named Effigy of Ceiling. Okay.
Oh, right next to us, you mean?
Is that it right there?
Yep.
Alright, well.
Beat it up.
It just says click on it.
Oop. Took me somewhere. Whoa, what's going on?
Ah, Star Blessed Scale, we got one.
Nice.
Alright, if you don't have silvery plate, go to C7, enter the door, and stand on the platform. It is required to ride the elevator to certain parts. We don't have a silvery plate, so we have to go to C7 now. C7 is probably on the other side of the fucking map. Yes, it is way over there. Alright, this will be fun.
Final Fantasy 11.
Alright, so, I imagine these things will probably murder us if we try to fight them, so let's try to sneak around it. I'm just gonna assume everything in this game will murder us now.
Yeah, pretty much.
We've reached the point where everything will just kill us.
Everything's just dangerous.
99, being level 99 will no longer save us. It's like that point I reached in Dragon Quest VIII when I got to the secret dungeons. The game was like, no, we're still going to fuck you up badly. And I'm like, well, shit, I thought I was good at this game. Apparently I am not. I'm that thing that... I am apparently that thing that is opposite of good at that game.
Which game?
Dragon Quest VIII.
Aww.
Final Fantasy XI, the Rock Fetch quests. Yes. Or like FF11. Ah, shit. Alright.
You wanna fight?
Guess we'll do this later, Reeve.
Alright.
Next thing we fight is gonna get messed up because I'm gonna give it a nice 3000 TP Howling Fist.
Let's fight this Protean.
Umbral is going down.
Yeah, that's right.
Took another 5,227 to the face. I'm only hitting by 300 and 100. What is up with this? So, Shan, what made you want to come back to FF11? I'm always happy to hear people coming back to the game, though, because this game is awesome. And I'm really happy I took the time to record it. Yeah, the music's great, isn't it? My favorite music in the game is probably still Aelnerx's battle theme, though. Paralyzed the fuck off. Lady Reaper, you keep hitting that silly help Lady Reaper on the mental tether. I'll deal with the Draugr. Come on, Olmia, turn the music up to Pure. Rebel theme from FF2, Yusuf? Well, I suppose that's true. It is a pretty good theme. Yeah, the fact that we were able to solo a lot of the content now made my stream a lot more easy to manage, I guess is the best way to put it. Could you switch to the best rate level, please? Thank you. Oh, Karamaru, shit, dude. Go.
He just used his cutter because he had no key.
Yeah. I'll handle those if we kill those. Yeah, it definitely made it a lot more possible for me to get all of this for my YouTube channel. I've recorded all of my streams of every Final Fantasy game, and I wanted to include FF11 in that. And I asked Silly to help me, and he was like, yeah, alright. Oh shit, I'm getting hit by something else. Alright, when you can. You guys killed the dimensional tether? Excellent, good job. Okay, that's that done.
Hang on for a sec. Eventually, when I flesh out my flourish 2, I'll be able to use 5 combo points to get 5 finishing moves to get 1,000 TP.
What, it's 810 now, or?
Yeah.
190 is still a significant increase.
Yeah, it's really good to get 1,000, because then you can automatically do. I mean, you usually melee right after, and it gets you pretty close, but. Yeah, I think it goes up to 1,000.
I think we should go down here since it's less likely to run into something, maybe? Must there be another colonization or a layer of raid left? What?
We got some thousands of experience from that.
Did we?
That's kinda good, yeah. We got 4,000 experience, 4,000 bales.
Awesome.
Well, that's what I got at least.
Well, I got much less than that, but that's because I was just fighting the Druid Goose.
Because you suck, that's why.
Yeah, that's probably a more accurate description.
Maybe if you weren't so bad, completing the objective.
That's true. Apparently I'm still blind. And that's a long status effect.
It lasts for a very long time.
Oh, look, Dullahan's. Hello, Dullahan. Will you murder us if we go near you? I'm gonna assume that you will. Cool looking though. We made it to C7.
Excellent. What's this going here?
Alright. Stand on the platform and try to drive the elevator out to certain points. Still on map 1, descend the routes at E8. Where's the door? There it is, I see.
After this, I have to get a haircut.
Okay, well, we're only going to complete this quest, so once we're back, we're done.
Yeah, I mean, I have plenty of time, because we don't have to be ready till 7, so. Those dual hands look cool.
Yeah, they are really cool looking character models.
Aggro on one of them?
Yeah, we're gonna
attacking.
Drag it over into this room, please.
Nah, dude, stand and deliver!
Yeah. 5,967, yeah. one thing Miro has, it's raw ability to deal 5,967 damage. Hey, 230 capacity points. See, those could be good to level on, because that wasn't too difficult. It's skill chain distortion, silly.
Yeah.
Is that because of you?
Maybe.
Don't be rude.
I was trying to get a light skill chain, but...
Ah, it wouldn't work, because I use Howling Fist.
Need a Yame to get light skill chains.
Yeah. Alright. So then when it says to... Okay, you wanna stop moving? Thank you. Okay, so it says go down the routes here, I think. Yes. On map 2, go to the elevator at H8. Alright, it doesn't exactly say. Just like, alright, that works. They're all at 8H. Well, there's two of them, but... I think we gotta go this way. Yes, alright. Get out of the way, Omia. So yeah, Shen, we actually haven't done any of this content either, so... you're gonna see us try to struggle our way through as we try to get along.
Keyword struggle.
Yes.
Is that thing that we were just looking past through that room? That's not one of the crystals we have to like click on?
The guide here didn't say so, so.
Okay.
I'm gonna trust it and assume not. Watch it actually is one of them though. Bats. Our nemesis. Heard a sound, sorry. Hey, I'm no longer blinded. Imagine that. Shen, do you remember which of the content you were able to do back in the day? Because I was able to do like none of it, so it was kind of cool to actually see it. So far, the Promivians are one of my favorite areas, though. Shundan Graybeard. Why are you running over here, Shun Valiant? Run somewhere else.
Something's attacking something. I heard a weapon in the sheath, I think.
Yeah, I heard one as well. Oh, the engraver's after you. So run into this room. Oh, there's two of them. Alright.
You pieces of shit.
They don't hit as hard as some of the stuff we've seen so far. Oh, it's a rune.
It's hitting me.
Yeah, but only for like 100. Some of the stuff we've seen can hit over 200, so... We can take a hit, though. That one.
They're just showing off now. Third point.
Rise of the Zealot.
Must be capped.
I am. Rise of the Zealot and most of the chains you've briefly got into treasures. Okay, that's actually pretty good, because Rise of the Zealot was awesome. You should finish Chains, because that ended up being pretty awesome as well. Plus Prish. When I first played, I had just gotten into Treasures as well. I was more for the leveling than anything. I was leveling in the thickets. Oh, quick cutscene. Never mind, not a cutscene. Well, kinda. Alright. Go to H2 and wide scan for an NPC statue. Okay, same as before, so let's go to H2. Oh, that is way the fuck up there. Okay. Well, this time we have to turn right at the top of this ramp. You want the Raja swing? This thing right here? I assume there's better rings than that now. I mean, we're level 99. I'm still using a level 30 ring. Then again, we haven't gotten too many accessories in that over our playthrough, which might seem kind of sad, but whatever. We do our best, all right? Oh, we should be able to just bypass it. Just run by it. There's no reason to stay and do this. Hours for Nier Automata. That's ridiculous, Yusuf. Good luck with that. I don't envy you on this. Okay, this room's filled with shit I don't want to look at. Hitting me. That's weird.
I know. I'm definitely just fighting these right here.
Yeah, we're gonna get three of them.
Oh, good. We're gonna die probably.
Probably. This is actually hurting.
Which one are you focusing on? The one that's dying?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't like
how is this thing. Oh, it's just kind of standing there. It's like.
Just watch your AoE attacks.
Well, I'm not gonna be attacking much in general. I just want to be able to heal.
Looks like you're attacking again, so.
That doesn't matter if I'm attacking. I don't think. Oftentimes I can't heal even if I'm attacking. Just keep getting more of them somehow?
No, we've had three. Oh, there's a fourth one now. God damn, I hate these things. I love that the timer wears off, and yet I'm still calling it. Like, what's that? What's fun having a number value on it if it's not gonna adhere to that value? Shan, are you looking to play a new class this time around? Also, if you want some good information, look up. Rick Wall on YouTube, his Returner series for all things Final Fantasy XI. It'll give you some really good information for coming back to the game. You finally finished beating Glavoid 30 times? Why would you do this? Okay, hang on. Gotta go to H2, I think, right?
Maybe.
H2 should be just up in here. Is that a dead end? It's a fucking dead end.
Oh yeah.
I hate this game. Alright.
Hate or love is the question.
I do think this place is rude as shit, so. Yeah, I don't envy you fighting Glavoid 30 times. That's fighting it once was enough. Silly should remember Glavoid.
I think so, yeah.
The largest thing you've ever fought in the game.
Ah, yes. The snake, the worm that blew our clothes off.
Yes. Oh, and Shan, Dancer for Solo is pretty good, actually. Silly loves it.
What's Dancer?
Exactly. Shan, be aware, if you plan to do Abyssi, that's when you're going to start running into monsters that will blow your clothes off. I'm not kidding about this either. They literally blow your clothes off. It's a fascinating thing. I think that's it over here.
How many skills do we need?
I think 3. This is number 2, but the other one looks like it's got less travel distance, maybe. Yeah. So we got moon scale. Okay, so it says enter the elevator from the north at I-6. So we are. Okay, so. Might be able to get there from just down there. This room. Shan, what? yeah. Oh, we aren't even kidding. We were fighting this giant worm in Abyssi, and it used this like breath attack, and then all of a sudden our characters are in their small clothes. We were like, what the fuck? it was a sight to behold. And then, sure enough, Adeline, the content we're doing now, had another monster that did that. And we were like, we actually lost to that. We lost to the worm in Abyssi too, but Abyssi fucking fuck off. That content's just annoying as shit. We did it though, that's the important thing.
We did it.
The heck? Oh, that's not our group. Okay. That's somebody else. We're good. I think this is where we have to be. Yes. Okay, this elevator's got the arrows pointing down.
Oh, snap. Now it's got arrows pointing up.
Vertical transit device. We gotta destroy the amaranth barriers at F6 and proceed to the room at C8. Okay, so if there's amaranth barriers, that's gonna be shit, but we're heading to C8. So F6, where is that? C8 is right there, and F6 is right there. Okay, so I see where we gotta go. Got one more Abyssi boss to fight for your Imperium weapon. Well, I hope you're able to get it, because that's awesome. But right now, oh yeah, Gammy, right now I'm using this Arisi Sainty. It's SU1. I thought this was good, but maybe it's not. It's giving me magic accuracy for some fucking reason. You'll make me dance. Why would you do this, Yusuf? Alright, so we gotta go to the other side of this room and then down the left side, but maybe it might be... Okay, so yeah, there's the Amaranthian barrier there, silly. Can we break this? Do we have the ability to do so?
I don't know.
Oh, well, we're gonna have to. If not, this is where we're done.
Can't disengage myself from your body.
We damage this. No. We cannot, so we cannot get through here. Be where we're done, because we can't do this in this week and we don't have the items to do otherwise, so. No worries.
All the frogs. Omia doesn't do it though. Omia's like, nah. I'll pass.
Side room and okay, so we're gonna leave the area here. We're gonna use our warp ring. That's where we're gonna be done for today, but we'll come back and next week we'll have the ability to complete this. So come over here, silly.
I can't.
Why? Oh, you're halted?
I'm sleeping.
Oh. That's always good. How long on your sleep?
39 seconds. You can end the stream if you want.
Well, I don't want to end the stream. I'm gonna warp back to town first. Warp ring out of here. Alright, so we went 15 minutes over our usual time, but that's okay.
I can attack again because something attacked me.
Excellent. You should be able to summon. No, you can't because I'm the leader. So yeah. While Silly's getting out of that mess, I will say goodbye to everyone here. The magic axe is for Puppeteer, yeah. Alright, so everyone.
thank you very much for viewing today. It was a lot of fun. We made a lot of progress. We got some good advice from Ogami and Lady Reaper. Hopefully next week we will be better geared for the content so we don't get as beat up by everything we run into. And we should have the quest done to break down Amaranth walls. I'm pretty sure we already picked that stuff up. So, if you want to see more, follow me here on Twitch. I would really appreciate it. Or just check out my YouTube. I post everything that you may have missed on there. Yusuf, always nice to see you. Tomorrow we'll be back for more Final Fantasy Chocobo's Dungeon from 12:30 to 2:30 EST. Silly, do you have anything going on next Sunday?
No.
Okay, so we'll probably be back with more FF11 next Sunday. Thank you again. Have yourselves a good one. We'll see you later.